The moment is all we are. We're quicker, quicker. Who cares if one more light goes out?
All right, now what you just watched was my Google Chromecast. It's actually a version 2 device playing on my TV. And it was also playing in a Google Home application group. So it was multi-room audio or multi-speaker audio there that you were watching. Now, why would you want to do this? Why would you want to use a Google Chromecast? Well, obviously, in a lot of homes in North America and the world over, the best speaker in the home is attached to the TV. People have the surround systems, all of those big speakers, or even the TV itself tends to be a great speaker in general. So, you know what, guys? It's time to get using your TV and its speaker system in your Google Home multi-room audio. If this is your first time on Automate Your Life, go ahead, click that subscribe button down below. Obviously, a video like today, what I'm here to do is give you back time in your life. A couple things before we get going. You need to be a part of the preview program today. That obviously won't be the case for very long, but right now you need version 1.36 or better in order to have your Google Chromecast, and that's a version 2 or a version 3 of the device. And if you have either of those two versions and 1.36, this is now available to you to play music with. The other thing you're going to want to do, unless you want to use your remote every time on your TV, is make sure that your HDMI ports can turn on the TV. So my Google Chromecast initially couldn't actually turn on my TV, and I have a Panasonic TV. I had to turn on basically the wake on or wake by device setting on my TV. Once I'd done that, then I was good to go. And basically, as soon as I started music, my TV turned on. So let me show you a quick demo of how that works. Play Foo Fighters on Basement Chrome.
Sure, Foo Fighters from Google Play Music, playing on Basement Chrome.
Volume to 100%. Next song.
So there you go. Obviously, I could start and stop the music, and I was controlling it through one of these devices. You saw me controlling it using this, but this is the Google Home Hub if you don't know. But anyways, I could control it through this, I could start and stop music, and this visual interface I think was really, really helpful to show you that the song was playing and moving along there and that the control was going on. And when I said start and stop, I could see that. You could see I could also raise and lower the volume. Your TV still has an up and down volume that you can use as well. So Google Chromecast is not actually changing the volume on your TV. It's changing the input volume to the Chromecast and therefore the volume overall. But you can also adjust your TV's volume if you've maxed out the Chromecast, you want it louder or quieter, whatever, what have you. The other thing I could do is I could go ahead and move back and forward in terms of songs. I could obviously change artist if I'd like, or playlist. If you're capable of doing that with a music service, you're capable of doing that on your Chromecast from now on. So in terms of actually getting your Chromecast working with that, that's about it. You can obviously control it through the app on your phone if you'd like. You can go through the casting capability there. But ultimately, I like the voice control and using another one of these devices. But you do not need that to actually work. You can go ahead and use the Google Home app. Now, moving on to multi-room audio and using a Chromecast within a multi-room audio system. Now, what you can do is you can go ahead and create a group. Now, I created a group called Gym Group, and that's as simple as hitting the add button at the top and going ahead and adding the different devices you'd like to that group. And once you've done that and you make sure you add your Chromecast to that group, then you're able to use basically that voice interface, or again, use the application to go ahead and cast music to it. So let me show you a quick demo. Obviously, all the same commands are going to work in terms of moving back and forth between songs, next and previous, volume up and down, choosing your artist, choosing a playlist, choosing a genre even, whatever you'd like. But ultimately, here's a quick demo of that getting started.
Play Foo Fighters on Gym Group.
All right, Foo Fighters from Google Play Music, playing on Gym Group.
A couple things you're going to notice right off the bat. There was no longer a visual interface on the Chromecast, and I don't know how long it'll be that way for, but for myself, Chromecast stopped showing the actual album cover from the band that I was playing. It started showing ambient mode, so that much had changed. What you were actually watching too was a Chromecast audio, the Google Home Hub, a Google Chromecast, and my Google Chromecast, which is a version 2. So that's what you were watching, and all four of those devices were synchronized. Now, talking about synchronization, because that is the most difficult component of this whole scenario, and it's not going to be easy for me to walk each one of you through how to do this, but here's what I'm going to tell you in terms of setting up and synchronizing a Google Chromecast with these types of devices. Now, first things first, what I'll say is my Google Chromecast was the device that was the furthest ahead in terms of how far the song had been played into. So it was the one that was the furthest ahead. The one that was the furthest behind was actually my Google Home, my standard Google Home device. This was somewhere in the middle or very close to my Google Home, and the Google Chromecast, the Chromecast audio rather, was very close to my Google Chromecast. So, you know, in general, what I'll tell you to do is find the device that's the furthest ahead in the song and find the device that's the furthest behind in the song. And what you do is you delay the speaker or the Chromecast. In my case, it was the Chromecast. I had to delay that the full 200 milliseconds that you have use of the slider, basically, inside of the application. I had to defer that 200 milliseconds fully to get it to basically synchronize with this device. Now, that's what you have to do. You identify the first and last speaker, and then you just make them all meet that last speaker based on delay. And unfortunately, if you have too much delay for some reason, you're not going to be able to do this. I wouldn't expect it. It's kind of expected that all the audio in your home should be around that timeline, but if you have additional Wi-Fi devices like a Wi-Fi extender, that's going to be something that's going to add another delay to your system. If you have other hops or other hubs, things that are kind of taking up lots of traffic, you may run into extra delay. So now let me actually show you really quickly. You can see in the first part of this, there is that funny delay, and really all I'm doing is moving that slider on my Google Chromecast to match up with my Google Home here, and then both of them are synchronized. And at that point, I'm able to synchronize everything. So you can see from the first to the last part of this next demo, the differential, and you can actually hear it synchronizing.
Who cares if one more light goes out in the sky of a million stars out? If a moment is all we are, or quicker.
Now, just to make sure you guys have everything clear here, I'm going to do a little demo just on my phone here to show you all the different components you're going to need. The first thing I'm going to show you in the Google Home application is how to make sure you're on the preview program. So in the bottom right of the Google Home application, there's basically a settings icon. You click on that and you go in and then you tap on settings. Once inside of settings, you're going to see account preferences. Tap on that and go to email notifications. Inside of there, you can see the preview program for Chromecast and Google Home. Now, once you tap that and you make sure that that setting's basically on, you're going to need to wait a little while for your Chromecast to upgrade if you don't already have version 1.36. And once that occurs, then you're able to use it in music and audio.
Now, in order to check that your device actually has the right version on it, you need to go to the settings of the actual device. So from the home screen in the Google Home application, you then tap on the device and then the gear up in the top right and scroll all the way down through the device settings to the bottom where you will see 1.36 or whatever the Cast firmware version is that you have on the device at this time. Now moving on to creating a speaker group, in the Google Home application again, the add button on the front page is what you tap on, then you're choosing create a speaker group, and now you choose the different devices. Now you can see top left, my basement Chrome, that is a Chromecast, that's the version 2 that I'm using in this demo, but you could have a version 2 or a version 3, as long as you have that right firmware version. Now you can tap on all the different devices you'd like to add, and then you simply put in a group name. Again, I'm calling mine Gym Group for this demo. Once that group is created, you can go in later into that same group and adjust which devices are in that group. So you're not stuck here. You simply go into the settings top right, and then you scroll down and you tap on choose devices. And you could add other devices if you'd like, or remove devices if you'd like as well. Once you've created that group, any application with a Cast icon in it anywhere will be able to choose that group. So you can see that I can choose the gym group, and there I go, I'm casting now to that group. In terms of synchronizing audio within a multi-room or multi-speaker system, inside of a Google Chromecast or a Chromecast audio device in the Google Home application, you will actually see the word sync audio or a button to press on. Once you press on that, you do get the slider, and this is where you adjust it, and it takes about a second for your speaker to actually adjust to the new delay that you've input. So as you move that back and forth, give it a second, make sure you let the speaker adjust. Once it's adjusted, go ahead and listen to the two speakers independently. What I was doing was literally putting my ear up to each of the devices and then just moving back and forth between them. Now, in terms of a Google Home, a Google Home Mini, or a Google Home Hub, it actually says that the synchronization process, which you have to find in the device's settings in the case of those devices, it actually says it's only working, this delay is only working with Bluetooth. That's not actually the case. I was able to adjust the delay on those devices as I wanted to. So I'm thinking this is just a typo and that Google will remove that over time.
All right, there you go, guys. Obviously, now you can get your Google Chromecast version 2 or version 3 set up, connected, and playing music in your home. You can use that TV speaker, and you can also go ahead and use it in groups in the Google Home world here. So go ahead, do that, get it set up. And of course, if you have any questions, comments, you're really struggling with something, go ahead, leave them down below in the comments. I'm happy to help as far as I can. Obviously, with that piece of troubleshooting there in terms of synchronizing your speakers, that's going to be relatively difficult for me to help with, but I'm always gonna try for you guys. So again, everyone, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.